Here are three things to consider when choosing the right breast implant for you. The first thing is how much breast tissue you start out with, or how is your anatomy? Because everyone's anatomy is different, and based on anatomy, that's gonna determine what kind, what shape, what style, what width breast implant you're gonna need. So don't forget to take into account that your anatomy plays a huge role in what your implants are gonna look like. So when you go in for a consultation and you talk to your surgeon, I'm sorry, I have an itch. My hair's growing out, it's driving me crazy. So you go and have a consultation. You're gonna see all of these implant options. You're gonna get to feel different ones, see what you like best. And he or she is gonna measure your breast width to determine the best width of an implant to fit your body. Now, a lot goes into that. You're gonna have to decide based on you, do you want more cleavage? Do you want more implant, more breast in the middle? Do you want side boob? And a lot of that depends on your anatomy too, because the further apart, the more wide your chest is, the more natural your breasts are gonna sit on the side. But if you communicate with your surgeon what look you want, he can tailor the implant to give you the look that you would like. So take that into consideration when choosing the look you want. Also, another thing I want you to take into consideration when choosing what implant is best for you is your lifestyle. Now, I know a lot of people say bigger is better, but not always. Like if you're someone who's really active, let's say you're into CrossFit or a lot of high intensity interval trainings, you're jumping up and down a lot and that sort of thing, you're probably not gonna want really large breasts because it will kind of inhibit your current lifestyle, and you don't want something that's important to you and that you're passionate about to have your breasts interfere with that, because it's not gonna make you feel that great about something that you want to be excited about. So take into consideration the type of lifestyle that you live. The third thing, bigger isn't always better. I know I touched on that on the second point, but like for me, I did want large breasts, but I didn't go as big as I wanted to the first time because, first of all, I didn't know if it would cause stretch marks. I didn't know if my anatomy would allow it first, because when you start small and you go too big, you're at risk for more complications. And sometimes, like they say in AA and NA, easy does it. So ease into it. Don't try to go too big too fast, because you can run into more complications than it's worth. So start modest, and then work your way up over time to give your chest and your muscles and your skin the time it needs to stretch, so you don't run into things like stretch marks or complications or any aesthetic difficulties coming down like that. It's better to be safe than sorry. That's how I think anyways. So those are three things to consider when you're choosing the right breast implant for your look.